Okay, page 4 of the sample final. So I have, I'll write f of x in order here. I have negative x squared plus 6x plus 7. It says, fine, determine what has the maximum or minimum. Since it's an upside down parabola, it's going to have a maximum. And then it says, find that value. Okay? Well, it's going to be at the vertex, which I have to do down here. So to do the vertex, it's minus b over 2a when we have it in this form. So that's going to be negative 6 over negative 2, which is 3. And if I plug 3 back in, I get negative of 3 squared plus 6 times 3 plus 7. So that's negative 9 plus 18 plus 7. It's 9 plus 7, 16. Yeah, 16. So the maximum is 16. The line of symmetry is x equal 3. Solve this. So let's just use what we know. See, there's no factors alike. So if I were to sketch a graph of this quickly, it has a vertical asymptote at x equal negative 5. And since it's a single factor, it goes opposite on either side of this. 2 minus x is 0 at 2. So vertical asymptote at 2. And single factor, so it's opposite. And this would be minus 1 for the, makes that factor equal 0. The x plus 1, so that's opposite. We have x-intercepts of negative 2 plus 3 and 0. Well, so we don't really have an indication yet of which way it's going to go, and probably if its x-intercept is 0, the y-intercept is 0. So now we're going to have to take a little bit of a look-see and figure out whether it's going positive or negative near one of these vertical asymptotes to figure out what's going on here. So I'll put in 2.1. So 2.1 plus 2 is 4.1. 2.1 minus 3 is negative 0.9. 2.1 in for the x over 2.1 plus 5 is 7.1. 2 minus 2.1 is minus 0.1. And 2.1 plus 1 is 3.1. And so I'm going to have a negative here and a negative here. They're going to be canceled, be positive. So I've got something that's going to be greater than or equal to 0. It is positive. So at 2.1, it's headed positive. It crosses here. But what is the horizontal asymptote? Well, let's see here. This is going to be x times x, which is x squared, or x to the third, as my power of x. The leading power, the degree of that one, plus some other stuff. And the bottom one's going to be x times a negative x times the x, so it's negative x to the third. So they're the same degree, So the ratio of the coefficients here of those is where the horizontal asymptote is, which is y equal negative 1. So there's this horizontal asymptote. So this thing gets closer and closer and closer to that. Well, then, as it gets out here in the large. Now, since it goes opposite, this must come from here. It must cross at 0. And so it must go up. It's not a bounce because it only happened once at 0. So if it's opposite, it must be down here, must cross here. So it must go up. So it must be down here and go off that direction because it was opposite. So we're not supposed to decide when this is greater than 0. None of this is greater than 0 or equal to 0. This part is from minus 5 to minus 2. Can't include the minus 5 because it's an asymptote, but we can include the 2 because it is equal to 0 at the negative 2. Union. It's also positive here from negative 1. That's an asymptote, so can't include it. Up to 0. Can include it. Union. And then finally from 1, 2. Can't include it to infinity, no, to 3. And we can include it. And that's it. And you could check that by typing this into your calculator as long as you make sure you put parentheses around all the numerator. So parentheses, x plus 2, close parentheses. Parenthesis, x minus 3, close parenthesis, and then x, and then close the numerator, divided by parenthesis for the denominator, parenthesis for the x plus 5, close parenthesis, parenthesis 2 minus x, close parenthesis, and parenthesis x plus 1, close parenthesis, close the denominator. Zoom 6 should probably do it. And I don't know if you can see it, but you should be able to see that it was this part here is here. And then we had it going down through negative 2, which it did. And then it jumped up to here and came down through 0, which we have. And then it jumped up again at 2 and came down below the x-axis, approaching that y equals negative 1. And I can even put in y2, negative 1 for the horizontal asymptote, just to graph it and see that it does get closer to and closer to that line. So there we go on that one. 12. Determine the real roots and imaginary roots, etc., etc., etc. So first of all, right away at this one, I can see there's an x in each term, so I'm going to factor it out. And that tells me 0 was one of them. And you'll see that in just a sec. X to the 4th plus 5x to the 3rd minus 7x squared plus, take it out, 5, an x out of 3 is 2, 5x squared, an x out of x squared is just an x to the 1, and then 2x minus, factor out an x is just 2. But let's go here to the calculator. Clear that, put in x to the 5th plus 5x to the 3rd minus 7x squared plus 2x, and we should see that it goes through 0 because that's one of the zeros, one of the roots. Now it's doing something in there. It's wiggling around, can't really see it, so I'm gonna go zoom 4. That might help me see it. Still kind of messy in there, so I'm gonna go zoom in, which is 2, and right in that area is still good. All right, so we've got 2 other ones here. Only 3 showing, so that means 2 are imaginary. So let's see if we can figure out either one of those. Now, once I took that out, I've got coefficients of x over coefficients of the constant, which is 2 or 1, factors of the constant over factors of the leading coefficient, which is 1. So the only nice places are 2, plus or minus 2, or plus or minus 1. And that's not cool. So these are not really nice numbers. They're going to be ugly, and so to do the synthetic division is going to be tough. Now, since I already took x out, I know 0 is one of the roots. It has multiplicity of 1. And because it went basically straight through. But now I've got 2 other ones here, and they're going to be not pretty. And I can use what's left here. So I've got 1x to the 4th, no x to the 3rds, 5x to the 2nd, minus 7x to the 1st, and a plus a 2. And I got to put into this 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. I got to put into this one of these 2. So I'm just going to find the first one here. That's 0. So I could calculate the 0. That's between 0 and, that looks like it happens to be 4.5. And I'm going to say it must be about 0.4. And it says no, 0.4092, blah, blah, blah. Now, it's already saved that as x. And that's what I got to put in synthetically, which is going to be tough. 0.4095271, and there's more to it. It saved more of it in here. So I've got to go 1 plus 0 is 1. Times x is going to be the 0.409 blah 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 blah. Add these, I'm going to get 0.409 blah 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 blah, which is my x. So if I quit on my calculator, you can see that x is that number. So I'm supposed to take that times that, which is basically x squared, and I get 0.1677 blah 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 blah, and to that I'm supposed to add 5, and I get 5.167 blah 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 blah, and now I'm supposed to take that times what's in my x, so I got to take that answer times x, and I get 2.11 something. And I gotta add a negative 7 plus a negative 7 or subtract 7. Enter, and I get negative 4.88 something. And I gotta take that times x. And I get negative 2 and it comes out to be 0. So if you work with the x that it saves in the calculator, you can do this with this ugly decimal. And now I got to do it with the other ugly decimal. Let's see, go back to the graph. I want this other one here that's just under 1. So second, calculate the 0 between 0.5 and 1. And it's about 0.7, I think. And it says, no, yeah, 0.79682. 0.79682 112, it tells me on this screen. If I quit and say X, it says 0.79682111194. So we will use that to try to figure out what this comes out to be. So 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 times this is what that X is, 0.7968. And I need to add it to that old X, which I just lost. I should be able to get close enough here if I just use, well, I'll type it in here because I have it here. I should have saved that in a different letter. Let me do that. I'm going to type in 0.4095271. I'll store that in A. Okay, so that's my A, and I have to add it to my X. Plus X. And I get this answer of 1.206. Ooh, shouldn't have gotten that. So it looks like something got fouled up on this problem. It won't be this messy on the test, but this one, my example here, I must have made a mistake when I multiplied. But anyway, I get that. And I got to take that times the X. Times X gives me this answer. And I got to add it to the 5.1 plus 5.1677. And there should be more here, but that'll be close enough. I took this times X, which was 0.9612, added to that, and I get 6.1289, blah, blah, blah. And I got to take that times X, and I get 4.883, which in the negative adds up to be 0. And now I got an ugly mess to put into the quadratic formula. Jeez. So I have a 0 of 0.4095, and it was once and it went straight through. And I have another one of 0.7968, single one, straight through. And then I've got this, which is going to produce two imaginary. And I would plug this into the quadratic formula to get it, but I'll use the program one. Since these are messy already, there's not going to be an exact answer. So go up to the quad formula. There it is. And I'm going to put in 1. 1.206. And 6.1289. Oop, and this calculator is not on real answer, so enter, and I got to go mode. I want to do complex answers. There we go. Second quit, program, quadratic formula. I want to put in 1.206 and 6.1289. Oh, this is messed up quadratic formula. It didn't give me the answers here. Somebody's messing around with my calculator here. Let's edit it and see what's going on. Yeah, it's only half there. Program, input, output, display, parentheses. Negative b minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac, close parenthesis for the numerator, divided by open parenthesis 2a, close parenthesis. Second quit. Do it one more time here. 1 1.206, 6.1289. There's my two answers. Negative 0.603 plus 2.401i and negative 0.603 minus 2.401i. Okay. So now we have a fifth degree. It crosses at zero. We determined that right away. It comes down and crosses at 0.409. Crosses again at 0.7968. And intervals where the function is increasing. It's increasing all the way up to that, the maximum, that local maximum. So I got to find that. So I'll go back to my graph. Want the maximum there. So I can calculate the maximum. That's between 0 and 0.5, and it's about 0.2. It says it's at 0.1766. 0.1766. So it's increasing from negative infinity to 0.1766. Then it decreases to that minimum. And then it increases after that. So second, calculate the minimum. That's between 1 and 2. Let's say it's between 0.5 and 2. 0.5 and 1, I mean. And 0.6. And it says it's 0.6378. 0.6378. From there to infinity, it increases. So up. These two should go up here also, but they don't have enough room. Okay, so that's the intervals where it's increasing.